Hello, I'm David Green, CEO of the Florida Pain Network, where we connect those in pain with pain relievers around the state. Today the topic is platelet-rich plasma. What is it? How is it used? It's a very exciting procedure. It's known as PRP for short. And basically, it falls into the regenerative medicine category. Most of the procedures that are used today in pain management basically mask symptoms, and they act as a proverbial band-aid. Now, they're a very good band-aid. It can be very effective for pain relief, for joint injections, epidural injections, facet blocks, things like that. But what we really want going forward are to add procedures that help regenerate and repair tissue, such as tendonitis, tendinosis, ligament problems, arthritis. You know, that's really the future. I heard a quote from a friend last month who said that 90% of regenerative medicine right now is used during surgery, but over the next 10 years there'll be a switch and 90% of it will be used to prevent surgery. So that's what we really want, and PRP is a very big step forward in doing just that. But what is it exactly? Well, about 30 to 60 cc's of regular blood are taken from a person's arm, like a blood draw, okay? That blood is then put into a machine called a centrifuge, and it gets spun around really, really fast for a few minutes. And it ends up in three layers. The bottom layer is mostly red blood cells, and that's discarded. The middle layer is called a buffy coat, and that's mostly white blood cells, and that's discarded as well. It's the top layer that has the platelets in it and all the growth factors from your blood that are used. And there's a few white blood cells still in there as well. Well, what does that do? Well, when that is injected into the problem area, and let's just use tennis elbow as an example. Tennis elbow is around the outside of the elbow. It involves where the muscles attach to that bone, the epicondyle, and it's an inflammation problem that can be very painful for a long time. You know, I've had it before for a year and a half, okay? Now, the objective is to avoid surgery. So injecting the PRP can actually cause a bigger inflammation reaction for a couple days and then really start a nice healing process for that area, as opposed to just a steroid injection, which is very good for pain reduction but doesn't actually fix the problem, right? So you inject the PRP, and what it does is it has these growth factors in it and the platelets, which can help the healing process, but it pulls in stem cells. Now, stem cells are what the body makes in your bone marrow that act as a clean slate of cells that can then differentiate into cartilage, tendon, bone, any type of cells where they're in the environment to do that. And that's what PRP is great at, is it doesn't have a lot of stem cells in the product, but it calls them in, and it's your own, okay? So it's very effective at that. Thousands of studies have been done on PRP so far. Before it was used in orthopedics and pain management, it's been used in urology, cardiothoracic, dentistry, and these new studies are showing good results, good to excellent results in pain management. They're small studies, so we're waiting for the big ones to come out, but they are being very effective. Three of the major sports leagues, the NBA, Major League Baseball, and the NFL, approve of the usage of PRP. They have seen some excellent results of some of the players in those leagues, and they're very excited. Okay, so what's it being used for? Well, like I mentioned, around the elbow, for tendonitis, tendinosis. It's used in the Achilles tendon. It's used around the hip and the shoulder, say for rotator cuff bursitis, tendonitis. And the latest is it's being used for arthritis. So it's being used for knee arthritis, hip arthritis, and it's showing some promise in helping with those conditions. So there's a lot of Florida pain clinics that are offering platelet-rich plasma. You can look on our website and find those that are closest to you at flrodapainentworkdotcom. Like I mentioned, the risks of PRP are very low. Okay, small risk of infection. There's really no risk of rejection because it's your own blood. Okay, and it's not covered by insurance yet. It's an outpatient procedure that you have to pay for out of pocket. But it is very attainable, and it doesn't cost thousands and thousands of dollars. So FloridaPainNetwork.com, click on I Need a Pain Clinic and just put your zip code in. It'll show you those that are closest to you. I'm David Green, CEO of the Florida Pain Network. Your pain stops here.